Hey everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play the Flintstones, the surprise at Dinosaur Peak. In our last episode, we did not one, not two, but three whole stages, and so, as you might expect, Fred and Barney were a little tired afterward. So I decided to let them take a little nap, you know, regain their strength a bit. Well, wouldn't you know it, as soon as they fell asleep, an evil spider wizard appeared, and he cast a spell on them. Yeah, pretty bad, right? Well, before we can go on, I guess we gotta go find that spider wizard so we can undo that spell. So, let's head into this house here. Oh, what kind of a spell was it, you ask? Well, as you can see now, it was a shrinking spell. Now Fred and Barney are only about the size of a giant coffee mug, so clearly they are in no state to climb Dinosaur Peak and talk to the fire dinosaur. So we have to undo this spell. But before we do, we can always have a little fun. Jump around in a giant toaster and whatnot. That's always fun. But yes, as you might expect, the game itself does not actually offer any explanation as to why there is a giant house in the middle of it, or, well, either a giant house or a shrinking Fred and Barney. But since they don't explain it, I figure my explanation is as good as any, so we'll go with that. This part can be a little tricky if you try to rush through it too fast. Just gotta wait for these frogs to jump at you, and then you can knock them right into the pit there. Pretty easy. So now we've got these underwater tunnels to deal with. This part of the level always reminds me of, I don't know, if it's one of the Kirby games, either Kirby's Adventure or maybe Kirby's Superstar. I think one of them has a level like this with all these underwater tunnels and currents and whatnot. But here we go, we can stop by this little area here if we want to replenish our energy. Still got four hearts, but might as well be safe. We get our mammoth-sized lunch. And now we are back on the road. And coming up ahead here, we've got another secret area. To get there, you just have to hold left as you're falling down here. Don't worry about the spikes. But yes, as you walk slowly against the current and fall down into this area, you will find another Shooting Star minigame. So in case you're running low on lives, which can happen your first couple of times through this game, you can always get a few more by picking up some of these falling stars. Now we've got about 15 lives, it looks like. Should be plenty to get us through the rest of the game. Yes, so as you can see, these stars just keep falling and falling. Grab the giant, whatever that thing is at the end. And now remember to switch to Barney here so that we can grab onto these poles here and get our lives back. And now we have, there he is, the spider wizard himself. I recommend using Fred here, because his club is more powerful than Barney's slingshot. Just wait for the spider to drop down, give him a hit, and repeat the process. Again, I think it'll go a little faster if you charge up your club before you hit him. And yes, here's his other maneuver. He shoots some little webs from the top of the screen, but pretty easy to avoid. So now we just wait for him to drop down again, and there we go. We get the magic crystal, which will restore us to full size. Alright, so now that we're back at full size, we can either keep going to that tower below us, or we can go to the arena and play another minigame. So let's do that first. Last time it was hockey, but this time it's basketball.
Hey Flintstone, if you win, I'll give you something.
Yes, back by popular demand, it is basketball. Now the object in this basketball game, or the strategy rather, is pretty much the opposite of the hockey game that we played earlier. In the hockey game, you wanted to let the enemy get past you and then check him from behind. In basketball, however, you want to always keep him in front of you, as I've just failed to do there. But yeah, as long as you keep him in front of you, it should be pretty easy to just check him, pick up the ball, and run toward the basket, just like this. The other thing to remember is that you don't actually have to shoot the ball up and into the basket. You can pretty much just stand right under it when his mouth is open and just toss it right into that pelican's beak, and you should be just fine. And well, that's the end of the first half, so now it's on to the second. And let me remind you again that these are the early 90s, and when I think of early 90s and basketball, it's only one thing that comes to my mind, and that is the theme song for the NBA on NBC, written by John Tesh, the one and only Roundball Rock.
Believe it. You beat me. Here's your prize. It's yours for keeps until you see game over.
All right, there you have it. We have completed the basketball challenge. And so I think this is a pretty good place to cut the video. So until next time, this is the Masked Cobbler saying so long and happy gaming. Bye-bye.